All right, it actually felt hot outside. I had my AC coming into work today. Nice change as we welcome in spring officially tomorrow. So today, last day of winter, but you know, here in Colorado, it's not done till the fat lady sings, right? Sam, I feel like last year we had a snowstorm, what? It was Memorial Day weekend?
Yeah,
it loves to hang on here.
Yeah, it's kind of typical for us to get some snow even into May, and I've seen it in the record books, us getting snowfall in June in Colorado Springs. So we still have a ways to go into the spring and summertime months before we can completely rule out snow chances. Definitely dealing with some snow chances this weekend on Sunday. I'll get to all of that here in a second. Current temperatures out there, mid-60s in Pueblo, low 60s for La Junta residents. Again, I check your surface sensors in Springfield, low 60s just to the south. We're having data issues there, 60 degrees in Alamosa. All of us a couple degrees warmer for our Saturday forecast. Then the cooling trend begins on Sunday. 15 miles an hour in Pueblo, Colorado Springs, similar with gusts to about 20 miles an hour on I-25. Nothing too problematic for travel conditions. It's really one of those events where it's just daytime heating. You get that upslope flow into the mountain ranges, and then at night you get the drainage winds. 33 degrees for Lamar residents, 36 overnight in Colorado Springs. Relatively warm, actually, considering the last couple of nights we were sitting in the low 20s and teens, mid-30s tonight. And then for tomorrow's forecast, 10 to 15 degrees above average for most. Check that out. 74 degrees Pueblo, 65 in Colorado Springs. I don't doubt it. We could get a degree or two warmer at times in El Paso County. It'll be a hot one across the plains. 51 degrees for Gunnison. And then for our Sunday forecast, this is where it's one of those things, all good things must come to an end. Upper 40s, and this complicates the forecast for Sunday. Considering just how warm we are for above freezing temperatures, about what, 17 degrees above freezing. So a vast majority of our precipitation on Sunday afternoon should be falling as rain, then change over to snow late Sunday night, and even an isolated shower too off in northeastern Park County, Jefferson County, not really affecting too many folks unless you're driving that pass just off to the northeastern side of Park County. So this is the cold front that will be responsible for the cooling trend on Sunday. It'll stall out across Wyoming and Utah overnight tonight and into your Saturday. So check this out. This is 6 p.m. this evening. And as we roll through our Saturday forecast, it really doesn't budge much until Saturday afternoon, 3 p.m. We're still partly cloudy in Colorado Springs, Denver. This ridge high pressure is still across Colorado. And then late Saturday night, early Sunday, that's when the cold front actually passes on by. And then we'll start to see that precipitation falling across the Palmer Divide for Monument, Larkspur, even Lyman potentially, up into Woodland Park for early Sunday afternoon. And then a lot of that rain and snow builds in for early Monday. And I think the biggest question mark with this forecast is how cold will Springfield and Lamar get? Because if you actually drop into the mid to low 30s, a lot of that rain could change over to snow, where you could see a couple inches of snowfall by mid portion of the day on Monday. But this model run's not picking it up. It's really not even seeing any snow chances across the plains. But again, it's possible for Bend County, Prowers County, Baca County to get a couple inches of snow, 2 to 4 in Colorado Springs by Monday afternoon. And I think that's on the high side of things, honestly. I'd go less than 2 inches in Colorado Springs, the metro area. But up into Monument, Woodland Park, you could be closer to that 4 to 5 inch mark by late Monday morning, early Monday afternoon. So if you are a commuter, it's something to keep in mind for the start next week. Canyon City into the mid 40s by Monday, as Sunday is the first day of the cooling trend. Again, enjoy tomorrow. A little bit of a breeze on Saturday, gust to 25, 30 miles an hour, but sunshine and warm temps. And then that rain snow mix starting during the late afternoon hours on I-25, then changing over those snow flurries by early Monday morning. Heather.
All right, Sam. Thank